is rising.
Praise is rising. Eyes are turning to you. We turn to you.
Hope is stirring.
Thank you.
Of your ways and
and your promises forever. Jesus, I believe. Jesus, I belong to you. You're the reason that I live, the reason that I sing. Jesus, I believe in you. Jesus, I belong to you. You're the reason that I live, the reason that I sing. With all I am,
worship him now.
I will worship. I will worship. I will worship. I will
worship our problems or the challenges we face. We do not worship finances or relationships. We only worship you. We put nothing else before you. You are the one we worship. Your son Jesus said we should worship the Lord our God and serve him only. We declare we serve the Lord and we worship the Lord our God only. And he is greater than any situation and circumstance and problem and issue and relationship problem and health, financial, whatever it may be. We state our dependence on you. We worship you. We call out to you. We cry out to you. Thank you that every living creature looks to you. We look to you today. You open your hand and you satisfy every living thing. You are righteous and faithful in all you do. And you are near to those who call on you, and you fulfill the desires of those who fear you. And you hear the cry of each and every one, and you step in and save us. And so we worship you. We worship you, Lord. We lift your name on high. We declare you are great. You are great and mighty. We look to you.
I will worship.
We've been talking about the kingdom of God since the start of the year, kingdom influence. And in a moment, I just want to touch on the enormous value of the kingdom of God. Please have a look at Matthew 13, and there's just three verses that I'd like to show you. Matthew 13, verse 44, 45, and 46, talking about the inestimable value of the kingdom. Matthew 13, 44 says, again, the kingdom of heaven. That's what we're looking about, our theme in church at the moment. The kingdom of heaven is like treasure hidden in a field, which a man found and hid, and for joy over it, he goes and sells all that he has and buys that field. See, the kingdom of God is like treasure. Verse 45, again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant selling beautiful pearls. In the day when Jesus spoke those words, pearls were one of the most sought after things in the world. Today, they're not quite as sought after, but they're still very precious. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant seeking beautiful pearls, who when he had found one pearl of great price, went and sold all that he had and bought it. I like how it is put in verse 44 in the Amplified Bible. It says, the kingdom of heaven is like a very precious treasure. Would you say very precious treasure? It's like a very precious treasure hidden in a field, which a man found and hid again. Then in his joy, like that lady's joy, he goes and sells all he has and buys that field. And in the Amplified, Amplified Bible, in brackets, it says, securing the treasure for himself. Listen to that. Securing the treasure for himself. Have you secured the treasure for yourself? Firstly, by Jesus being invited into your life, but secondly, by making it your pursuit that you will pursue the kingdom of God. Have you made the kingdom your treasure? I ask you today, how valuable is the kingdom of God to you? Is it something that occasionally you think about and you feel it is important? Or is it something that really consumes you, really determines the decisions you make, the directions you take, and how you invest your time? Do you see it as very precious treasure? Matthew 6:21 says, for where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. Where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. I want to ask you today, what is your treasure? What are you pursuing? What are you after? We're all after something. What are you pursuing? We need to see the kingdom of heaven as a very precious treasure. It's a very precious treasure. Let it be your treasure. I wrote two sentences here. The kingdom of God is more valuable than anything else we can have. Another sentence, the kingdom of God is so valuable that it calls for complete investment. And you know, the Apostle Paul, he understood this. And he lived a life pursuing God like nothing else. He actually said the same thing about the treasure, but he said it with different words. In Philippians 3, verse 7 to 9, this is what Paul said. I once thought that these things, and I'd like to say these things being other treasures, I once thought that these things, other treasures, were valuable. But now I consider them worthless because of what Christ has done. Yes, everything else is worthless when compared with, listen to this, the infinite value of knowing Christ Jesus my Lord. That sounds to me like the inestimable value of the kingdom of God, the enormous value of the pearl of great price. For Jesus' sake, I have discarded everything else, counting it as garbage so that I could gain Christ and become one with him. I no longer count on my righteousness through obeying the law. Rather, I become righteous through faith in Christ Jesus. And this is what communion is about. Communion team, would you please get ready to serve the elements? Communion is about not counting on our own righteousness, but through faith, receiving the righteousness of Jesus upon our lives. So we're going to serve communion now. Communion is open to everyone who knows and loves the Lord Jesus. If you know and love the Lord Jesus, you're welcome to partake. Even if you're watching this at home, you're welcome to partake as well if you love Jesus. Maybe get some juice, get a bread, piece of bread or a cracker, and you can partake as well. The scripture says in Matthew 26, this is as Jesus was meeting with his disciples. It says, now as they were eating, Jesus took bread and broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take, eat, this is my body. And he took a cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, drink of it, all of you, for this is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many for the forgiveness of sins. Folks, aren't we blessed to partake in communion, knowing what it means? Wow. Thank you for your mercy, Lord. Thank you for your mercy. And Lord, we lift up the bread right now in prayer. We do know that your word teaches us that the bread represents the body of Jesus Christ, which was nailed to the cross. As we break this, we remind ourselves of the fact that your body was bruised and broken and marred beyond human recognition. It was unthinkable what was done to you, unthinkable cruelty. But you did it out of your love for us. And that just tells us you love us so much. And thank you for, through your broken body, we can be made whole. The body of the Lord, broken for you. Lord, now we take the cup. We lift up the cup in worship and in devotion before you. We thank you that the cup represents the blood of Jesus, and the blood of Jesus ratifies the covenant relationship that we have. Wow. A covenant written in the blood of the Lamb, who takes away the sin of the world. Lord, we take a moment to bring our own hearts before you. Lord, we're sorry for the times when we blow it. Sorry for things that we've said and done lately that just haven't been right, haven't been righteous. We confess that to you. And thank you that if we confess our sins to you, you will forgive us and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Right now, we want to receive your cleansing afresh, knowing that we're walking in covenant with you, the blood of the Lord shed for you. Maybe you just want to keep your eyes closed for a few moments. The worship team can come closer. But just consider for a moment how wonderfully blessed you are that you have been made the righteousness of Christ. Therefore, I speak regarding any condemnation that may be on the people of God, and we say, be gone in Jesus' name. We are righteous, not because of what we've done, but because of our faith in the righteous one. And we declare, Jesus, you are our righteousness. We pray, Lord, as we go into this week ahead, that we would go in your victory, knowing that we have everything that we need for life and godliness. We pray that you would give us success in our work, in our business, in our teaching, in our practices, that we would be those that take dominion, that extend your kingdom, and those that set a godly example in the world in which we live. Thank you for your presence that goes with us. And I pray for everyone here for a blessed day further with family and friends. And we just say thank you for your goodness, Lord, in Jesus' name. And we all say, amen. Amen.